हेलो माय डियर फ्रेंड, सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व द वैलिड पैरेंथेसिस प्रॉब्लम। सो व्हाट विल बी गिवन इन दिस क्वेश्चन? इन दिस क्वेश्चन अ स्ट्रिंग विल बी गिवन टू अस। ओके, एज यू कैन सी इन द एग्जांपल वन, अ स्ट्रिंग इज गिवन। सो इफ द स्ट्रिंग इज परफेक्ट, इट मीन्स इफ देर इज ओपन ब्रैकेट एंड देर इज अ क्लोज ब्रैकेट, देन वॉट यू हैव टू डू, यू हैव टू डू रिटर्न द ट्रू। इफ यू सी द सेकेंड एग्जाम्पल, see for first string there is a closing bracket, for second there is a closing, okay, so for each string there is a closing bracket, so here also what you need to return true. But if you see in the third example, one it is opening and then it is square closing, okay, so they are not equal, so what you have to do, you have to return it as false. So a string is valid when open bracket must be closed with the same type of bracket. Okay, suppose if there is a open bracket like this, so it should be closed with the same this bracket, okay, and there can be multiple combination also. It is not fixed that the next bracket should be in the front of that, okay, it means it can be like this, 1, 2, then flower, okay, this can be also the situation, and in this case also you need to return the value as true. Why true? Because these are perfect pairs, this is perfect pair, this is perfect pair, all the brackets are in perfect order. If suppose we change the order, if we do like this, so now they are not balanced, okay, now they are not balanced because this bracket is completely balanced. Now here it is a square opening and here it is a normal closing bracket, so they are not balanced. So in this situation what you need to do, you need to return the value as false. Okay, so this is the thing that we have to deal with. So we are not sure that we will get the closing bracket next to the opening bracket. Okay, so every opening bracket should be a proper closing bracket, then we will get to the solution. Okay, so how we will approach this question? So we got to know that we have to match the brackets, right? So we have three opening brackets like this, okay, these are the three opening brackets. For these three opening brackets there should be a closing bracket and they are fixed. For this it is the closing bracket, this is square and this is flower closing bracket. So what you have to do, whenever we take a string as an input, suppose let's take a complex example only, okay, this and this also like this, this is the string that we have. So first of all what we will do, as soon as we get an opening bracket we are going to store it somewhere, it's also an opening bracket, we are going to store it somewhere, it's an opening bracket, we are going to store it somewhere. Now as soon as we start getting closing bracket, what we will do, we will pop up this last element, okay, what we will do, we will pop up this last element and we will compare whether it's the closing bracket or not. It means if we got this closing bracket, so what we will do, we will pop up this element. So now this list have only two element, we will check if they are making a proper closing bracket or not. If they are making the proper closing bracket, then it's okay, okay, we are going to leave it, then we will move to the next character. So we got one closing flower bracket, so what we will do, we will again pop up the element and we will check if they are making a perfect pair or not. If they are making the perfect pair, then it's okay. If they are not making a perfect pair, what we are going to do, we are going to return the false, okay. So they are making the perfect pair, then it's okay. Now we will move next element of this string. We got one closing bracket, we will pop up the list from the list that we have, and what we will do, we will check whether they are making a perfect pair or not. If they are making the perfect pair, then it's okay. If they are not making the perfect pair, we are going to return it as false, okay. So this is the example. Suppose here we get one closing bracket. So now what we will do, first of all, as soon as opening bracket, we will insert the element, here also insert the element. As soon as we got the closing bracket, okay, So what you will do? You will pop up the last element. Now you will see, are they making any perfect pair? If no, directly return the false. There is no need to check the rest of the elements. Okay, so here we will directly return the false. Perfect. So this is the main idea that we are going to use. Okay, so now to solve this, what we will do? We will make a stack. Okay, what is stack? Stack is like this. So as soon as we get an opening bracket, we are going to insert the element. Okay, so we have three opening bracket here. So I have inserted them. As soon as we got the closing bracket, what we will do? We will pop out the element. So we will get, we will do the comparison. If they are matching, then okay. If they are not matching, return the false. So suppose here it is, if they are matching, then it's okay. We will move to the next element. Again, we got a closing flower bracket. We will pop up the top element from the stack and then we will compare. Are they making a pair? If they are making the pair, it's okay. If they are not making a pair, return false. Okay. Then we will pop up the last element. First of all, we will reach the last element of the last character of the string and we will see that it is a closing. So closing bracket. So if we get any closing bracket, we will pop up the element from the stack and then we will try to match. If they are matching, then it's okay. Otherwise, we are going to return the false. Okay. So at last, if the stack becomes empty, it means we have no element in the stack. Suppose we have like this. Okay. There is a opening bracket for this. There is an opening bracket, but there is no closing bracket for this. So suppose if we have elements like this, so what we will do, we will pop up as soon as we reach here and they are matching, so it's okay. Then we will come to the next element and we will see again they are, it's a closing flower. So what we will do now, but now the list becomes empty. But here this is the perfect pair, this is the perfect pair, but there is no perfect pair for this opening one. It means we have some element in the stack. So if length of stack is greater than 0, at that time also what we need to do, we need to return false. Because if there are element in the stack, then it means we have something which is some bracket that are being opened but that are not properly closed. That's why we have this scenario. Okay. Now, okay, I think I have given you the complete concept. So let us start writing the code for this. So code will be very simple. So first of all, let us write the function name is valid, which is going to take a string as an input. Okay. So first of all, what we will do, we will make a stack. Okay. Now what we are going to do, we are going to write a for loop that is going to traverse the entire length of string. Okay, it is going to traverse entire length like this. Okay, so first of all, we will be at first element. So I will write the condition. If s of I equal to flower opening bracket, or s of I equal to opening bracket, okay, like this, or the third condition, or s of I equal to square opening bracket. So if we get any one of the three opening bracket, what we were doing, we were inserting the element in the stack. So just insert the element in the stack. So it will be like this, stack dot append, and we will insert that element s of I. So if they are not the elements from these three, it means they are the elements which are closing. So what I told you, as soon as we got something closing bracket, what we were doing, we were pop up the element. So x will be equal to pop up the top element of the stack. Once the element is pop up, what we were doing, we were comparing. Suppose here we reach to this element, okay, this one, this closing flower bracket. So we will pop up the element from the stack. So in stack, what is the top element? this opening flower bracket. Now what we will see, if we will apply the condition like this, if x equal to, okay, so here what is the value of x? X for s is the opening flower bracket. Now if x equal to opening flower bracket, okay, then the element of the string should be closing one, and element of the string s of I should be equal to closing one. Okay, if it is opening, the s of I should be closing one, then it's correct. Okay, if they are not equal, if they are not equal, then what we were doing, we were returning the false. So we will return the false here. So this is the first if condition. Now if the element that we pop up is like this, so the element inside our string should be the closing bracket. If they are not equal, so not equal, so what we were doing, we were returning again here false. Okay, here we can write else if. Else if the element is square opening, so the element inside, so the element in our string should be the square closing. If they are not, so what we were doing, we were returning false. Okay, so we handle this situation correctly. So once this if else, once this for loop ends, what we will do, we will check the length of string. If length of stack is greater than 0, it means if there are some elements in the stack, it means there is some opening bracket that have no proper closing bracket. So what we were doing, we were returning false. Else what we were doing, we were returning true, right? So this is the thing that we have done now. Okay, so I think you are feeling that this code is correct, but this code is going to fail sometime. How this code is going to fail sometime? Okay, I will tell you one situation. Suppose if the string have closing bracket and closing bracket. So if we got string like this, okay, so what you will do, first of all, what we will do, we will check if there is any opening bracket. There is no opening bracket, so what we will do, we will not insert any element in the stack. Then we will come to this else part, and what we will do, we will try to pop up the element, but the stack is already empty. How will you pop up any element? So what you will get here, you will get some error. It will say that there is no element in the stack, so how you can pop up the element? So you have to deal with this situation also. So if you get the first element as the, suppose, closing bracket, then it means the brackets are perfect when it is first opening then closing. But if you directly get the closing bracket, it means they are not perfect. So before pop up, what you have to do, you need to check once that whether if length of stack is greater than 0, then only pop up and check the elements. Okay, then only this condition will be applied. Okay, if there is no element in the stack, so what you can do, you can directly return false. So return here, return false. Okay, else return false. Now the code is completely clear. So here it's completely messed up, you can see it here. Okay, so first of all, we have written isValid function, then we have defined the stack, then we have traversed the entire string, and if it is opening bracket, what we were doing, we were appending in the our stack. Now first of all, we checked whether the stack is having some element or not. If stack is having some element, then only we will pop up and do the checking of our condition, that if we pop up, if it is opening bracket, the element in the string should be closing bracket. If they are not closing bracket, we will return it false, and we will do the rest of the checkings. Then if there is no element in the stack, it means the first letter that we have got is the closing bracket. It means we will directly return the false. So this is the exception that we have handled. And in generally, if any element left in the stack, so what we were doing, we were directly returning the false. And if there if the length of stack is 0, and that at that time we were returning at true. So this is the one of the approach to solve the problem. आई कैन टेल यू वन अदर अप्रोच ऑल्सो, बट इट विल बी ऑलमोस्ट सिमिलर टू दैट. ओके, बट आई विल टेल यू द अप्रोच. सो देर इज़ वन मोर वे टू राइट द सॉल्यूशन. ओके, सो हियर वी वर यूजिंग इफ कंडीशन टू राइट द सॉल्यूशन, राइट? हियर वी वर यूजिंग दैट इफ इट इज ओपनिंग देन वी हैव टू सी फॉर द क्लोजिंग. सो इंस्टेड ऑफ राइटिंग लाइक दिस वी कैन यूज द डिक्शनरी ऑल्सो. ओके, अप्रोच विल बी सेम, वी आर गोइंग टू यूज द स्टैक, बट या इट विल बी अ टाइम एफिशियंट इफ वी यूज द डिक्शनरी, राइट? सो अगेन द फंक्शन नेम विल बी सेम एज इनवैलिड, इज वैलिड, सॉरी नॉट इनवैलिड, विच इज गोइंग टू टेक वन स्ट्रिंग. सो हियर वट वी आर गोइंग टू डू, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी आर गोइंग टू असाइन अ डिक्शनरी. लेट्स से द डिक्शनरी नेम इज DIC. ओके, सो इफ इट इज अ ओपनिंग ब्रैकेट वी आर गोइंग टू लिंक विद द क्लोजिंग ब्रैकेट. सो दिस इज की एंड दिस इज वैल्यू. सो दिस इज की एंड दिस इज वैल्यू फॉर दिस. अगेन इफ इट इज अ क्लोज स्क्वायर ब्रैकेट, ओपन स्क्वायर ब्रैकेट, सो इट इज गोइंग टू बी मैप्ड विद द क्लोजिंग वन. इफ इट इज अ ओपन फ्लावर ब्रैकेट, इट इज गोइंग टू बी मैप्ड विद द क्लोज फ्लावर ब्रैकेट. सो दीज आर द थ्री एंट्रीज दैट वी आर गोइंग टू हैव इन अ डिक्शनरी. अगेन वॉट वी आर गोइंग टू डू, वी आर गोइंग टू डिफाइन अ स्टैक लाइक दिस, राइट? नाउ वॉट वी विल डू, वी विल ट्रेवर्स द एंटायर स्ट्रिंग. सो फॉर एवरी कैरेक्टर, फॉर कैरेक्टर इन एस, वॉट वी विल डू, इफ दैट कैरेक्टर इन डिक्शनरी DIC, ओके, वॉट इट विल डू, आई विल टेल यू द एग्जाम्पल साइड बाय साइड. सपोज द स्ट्रिंग इज लाइक दिस. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल हैव दिस ओपन स्क्वायर ब्रैकेट. सो हियर इट विल चेक इफ दैट कैरेक्टर इज देयर इन द डिक्शनरी. सो इट विल सर्च इन द की. सो इट्स देयर, यस इट्स देयर. सो वॉट वी विल डू, वी विल अपेंड द स्टैक. सो इफ इट इज एग्जिस्ट, वॉट वी विल डू, वी विल डू लाइक दिस, स्टैक डॉट अपेंड द कैरेक्टर. वी विल अपेंड दैट कैरेक्टर, राइट? सपोज if we reach to the next element, it's also present in the stack, it will append. As soon as we reach the third element, what we need to do? As soon as we reach the third element, we need to check now that it's not present in the dictionary. It means it is a closing bracket. So we need to pop up the element from our stack. So in our stack, we have two elements till now. So what we will do? We will pop up the element. So else if, what we will do, we will pop up the element. So stack dot pop. So what it will do, it will pop up the element. This element will be pop up. Now what I will do, I will for this element, I will search the in the dictionary what is the value. So what I will do, I will write DIC and the element that is popped. So this was the element popped. I will search in DIC this element. So what will be the value of this element? It will be this closing bracket. So if you are going to write this, what you are going to get? Finally, you are going to get this. So if the element that we popped up is not equal to the character, is not equal to the character. What is the character? Character is here because we were traversing. So character was this one, right? So we popped up, first of all, we popped up the top element. And then we searched in the dictionary. So we got this closing. Now we checked if this closing is not equal to closing. It means return false. What we will do? Return false. Right. Again, we have to check for the special condition that I told you in the last. That suppose if we got the first element as the closing. Closing bracket. So now, what it will pop up? It will not pop up anything because stack.pop will give us the error. So before popping up, what we need to do? We need to check for the length of stack. So let me write. First of all, what we will do? First of all, we will check the length of stack here. So else if length of stack equal to 0, or now write the condition that we have written, DIC stack.pop not equal to character. So first of all, if this will check the length,
If the length is 0, it means there is no element in the stack. So what we will do, we will directly return the false. And if we have some element in the stack, then we will check this condition. Okay, pop up the thing. Okay. Right. I hope it is clear now. So it will return the false. Now at the end, what we will do, we will check if there any element left in the stack or not. So if the length of stack is greater than 0, it means there is some element. It means there is some open bracket that is not matched. So what we need to do, we need to return false, or else what we need to do, to return true. So this is the logic. So what we have done this time, we have used the dictionary. Okay. So that we don't have to individually compare the elements. Okay. So if you want to see the code for this, so first of all, I have written a dictionary where I have written key value. Then I have defined a stack. Okay. Now I have traversed the each character in the string, and I have checked whether that character is existing in the dictionary or not. If it is an open bracket, then we are going to append it, or else we are going to check whether the length of stack is 0 or not. If the length of stack is 0, it means first element that we have got is closing bracket. So directly we will return the false. If this condition is not true, we will check for the second condition. In OR, if first condition is false, then only we will check the second condition. Then we have popped out the element from the stack, and then we have tried to find out the value of for that element that is popped out in the dictionary. So if it is an opening bracket, so it should be paired with the closing bracket. So if they are not equal, then also return the false. And at the end, if we have some element in the stack, return false, otherwise return true. So I have run this code, and as you can see, it is faster than the 91% of all the submissions. And the last code that we have written was also faster. It was faster than 89%. So these are the two different ways to write the solution. Okay, I hope you have got how I have written the solution. If you have other method, please let me know in the comment section. If you have any doubt, please let me know in the comment section. If you find these videos useful, you can share these videos with your friends. And if you are new to the channel, subscribe it for the further updates. Thank you.